Imagine you are running a furniture store and a young couple who recently moved together enters your store. How should you have arranged your assortment? Should you better have it arranged by substitute products, by similar products, like putting tables together, wardrobes together, closets together? Or should you have better arranged it by purchase goals, like putting together complementary products, like putting together everything that belongs into a living room, into a kitchen, into a bedroom, or into an office? How would the organization of your assortment impact your customer's journey? And what would be their purchase behavior? We will find out. Should you arrange your assortment by substitutes or by complements? Researchers ran an experiment in the grocery store and they changed the assortment organization. Randomly across weeks, they either had a substitute-based assortment, where they had eggs together, cereals together, milk together, and so on. And on the other hand, they grouped them together by the purchase goal, like having a breakfast. And this is what they did. They grouped products together to purchase goals. First with breakfast, but also with putting together produce, fresh meat, canned food into a main course organization, putting cake mix, baking powder, chocolate chips into a baking and dessert organization, and they group carbonated drinks, chocolate and nuts in another week into snack and candy. What has happened? The researchers found out that customers would spend on average 9% more in the complement-based organization versus the substitute-based organization. And why is that? The complement-based organization reminds customers on what they still need to accomplish their purchase goals. The complement-based organization facilitates a cross-selling and thinking about additional products and recognizing the need for additional products. That's why an organization according to complementing products works best. We looked at furniture stores and we looked at grocery stores as potential use cases to apply complement-based assortment organization versus a substitute-based assortment organization. But where else could we find use cases? For example, in apparel stores, you could group your products by suits, shirts, jackets, or you could group them by the purchase goal, like the occasion when they need these clothes, like sportswear, casual, office, or wedding and parties. Or in the financial services industries, you have loans, credit cards, insurance, or investment advice, but you could also group them by different stages in a person's life cycle, like just married, baby born, freshman at university, or fresh retiree. These are additional use cases to apply complement-based assortment organization. I hope I left you with a spark of inspiration, and if you seek more inspiration on psychological pricing or pricing in general, join me at pricingnuggets.com. See you there!